A wise man once said, knowledge is power. But did you know that the main cause of these full stack divines and winged scarab explosions are a result of unique items getting converted? But did you also know that how much of a massive role reliquary scarabs has to do with this? This video should help you learn more about the secrets of the Viridian Forest and why tornado shot builds are gathering more wisp than other magic find builds. And if you find this guy in the forest, do not whisper his name. Hello everyone and welcome back. Before I explain the Maxroll guide for Affliction League by Grimro, I would like to share some very interesting stuff that I discovered from data miners and from a dev currently working at GGG. For starters, there's a whole bunch of contradictory facts going around with regard to the effect of rarity in loot drops. One of which is that the amount of rarity from gear and party has no effect in getting stacks of divines and wing scarabs. To test these rumors, I ran several maps with meticulous appraiser and the results were stunningly bad that I can confidently report that there was no stack of divines nor any wing scarabs without the quantity factor. However, most of the few dropped items were either rare or uniques, which could have been converted into a few divines and wing scarabs though. So what about negative rarity and high quantity? So according to data miners, rare monsters in PoE have various modifiers with lines such as dropped items are converted to basic currency items based on rarity. If you notice the tag rarity, this is referring to normal, magic, rare, and unique. Well, theoretically, when you kill a rare monster, say the first archnemesis modifier is dropped items contain a fractured mod. The number of these drops is obviously scaled by the quantity factor. With high rarity, most of these are converted into rare items, and some into unique items. With no or negative rarity, all or most of these will be scarred items that will be ignored by your loot filter. They won't even have the effect of the archnemesis conversion. But when you use reliquary scarabs, on the other hand, you get a separate set of uniques, separate from the whole rarity factor. This was made clear to me when I ran several maps with and without gilded reliquary scarabs. So whether you have no rarity on your gear, if you were to use reliquary scarabs, you will still drop tons of uniques based on the quantity factor. So the question here is, does rarity on your gear and maps improve the quality of the loot that you get? To answer that, let's hear it from the man himself.
Rare monsters themselves drop better items than normal. Each additional Arch Nemesis mod drops more and more items in a multiplicative kind of stacky way. This, of course, all stacks with your player rarity and quantity, which does matter a lot more than before. Then, some of the mods have conversions that occur, and those conversions can stack together. And the goal is that player rarity and quant both affect all of these conversion things. And this means we have internal calculations now where for monster drops like this, your player rarity can actually convert currency items to better currency items. So if you get a currency item drop and you've got a lot of rarity, you're potentially having a higher chance of better currency in there internally. And so we're trying very hard to make sure that killing rares is a very rewarding experience.
Now, coming back to the dead monster. So imagine if you have a mix of magic, rare, and unique items in your drops. If the monster has a second modifier, say dropped items are converted to scarabs based on the rarity, the scored items will turn to rusted scarabs, magic into polished, rare into gilded, and uniques into winged scarabs. This is exactly how it works for basic currency drops as well, except it's augmentation, alterations, chaos, and divine orbs. Now here is the unfortunate situation you never knew. If the monster had a third archnemesis modifier, say, dropped items are converted to full stack of Orb of Fusing, this means all of your beautiful scarabs or divine drops are forced to be converted into a singular item based on the quantity of the loot. Did you also know that these kind of forced conversion modifiers are quite common? And this is why you see tons and tons of full stacks of Wisdom Scrolls, Jeweler's Orb, and Fusings. This can actually be a sad fate of losing a good potential of drops. So ideally, the loot conversion should end at the one we want. I personally do not like this, nor any other gambling mechanics in PoE. But if you look at the sheer reality of the game, everything is indeed a gamble, unless you are farming Waldo's puzzle boxes with a proper build. But here is a point of encouragement for you. If you run these magic find strats with high level investment in several maps following a solid guide such as the one from my previous video, you are guaranteed to make high amount of profit. I have playtested it and I love it, which is why if you have not watched my previous video, you are missing out on a ton of information, even if you're not magic finding. Gathering high amounts of wisps is the key element for everyone, unless you're just farming ultimatum. Gosh, I've always hated that. Of all the Magic Find builds out there, the reason why Tornado Shot builds are making more profit out of Wisp farming can be summed up from Rax's clip, where he made more than 11k of juice. Notice that each step of the way, he keeps shooting. Now the interesting part about Tornado Shot is that these projectiles are so many and they travel pretty far as well. Now if you have played a Deadeye with Tailwind, you know it requires quite a lot of attack speed to maintain 10 stacks of Gale Force. He's using Mana Forged Arrows with Frenzy of Onslaught to taunt the enemies every step of the way. It hasn't even been long and he has gotten more than 3000 of the Blue Wisps. He completes the event and at this point, I can clearly say that he has just started. Now another thing you would have noticed is that he's following the Wisps. And when the trail ends, he follows the monsters, carefully taking his time every move while shooting. Now he's run out of the trail, but he kills a monster off-screen which sends out the Wisps towards him. This is where he realizes that there's an event in the north. And bam, there it is, White Wisps. I don't know if you have noticed, but if you actually count the number of steps and compare it with your average, he hasn't even walked that far. He has over 9000 Blue Wisps and about 2000 of yellow before even backtracking to grab the rest of them. So what is the difference between your runs and this run? Monster kills. That's right. This is why, if you are magic finding, I would highly recommend a build with high projectile speed. If you were unfortunate to spend mirrors into your Fulcrum or Caustic Arrow build like I did, do not worry. You can use a separate character, preferably a Deadeye, to farm for Wisps in the Viridian Forest, and then switch to your favorite character once you're done with it. Which brings me to another interesting thing.
A new finding by Snowbay shows that if you resize your screen to be as wide as possible, you can easily find White Wisps at the edges and corners of the screen. You will have to switch to the windowed mode to resize your PoE screen. This is completely ethical and will by no means get you banned in any sort.
So according to the Maxroll guide by Grimro, the yellow ones multiply your quantity factor in every way except for the loot from Harbingers and Expedition currencies. He even mentions that this can even triple the loot from the empowered monsters. The pink wisps only affects the player and map rarity. This has no role in getting special items such as fractured shards. If you have been getting tons of awakened sextants, this confirms that the blue wisp touched monsters drop basic, exotic and even map currency items. Now interestingly, I bet you didn't know that Valdo's puzzle boxes and Voidborn reliquary keys are also considered as map currency items. So this is why you should focus on collecting as many yellow and blue than the pink ones. Examples of some exotic currency items include Aldridge Exalted, Annulment and Chaos Orbs. If you notice some rare monsters not touched by any wisps, this is mostly because you haven't gathered enough wisps. Every enemy shares the same chance to be empowered, so gathering more wisps or adding more monsters to your maps is the best way to increase the total empowered monsters. Another interesting thing is that the quantity of a wisp type also buffs the effect of the empowerment. So if you gather 10k of blue wisps like Rax did, it will result in a massive currency items dropping. If you watch the remaining of his video, you'll notice tons of exotic and map currency items dropping. Now this part might spark a debate in the comment section, and some of which I do not 100% agree with. But here Grimro says that a combo of blue-pink yields guaranteed currency drops from all enemies and increased rarity of those currency drops. This combo drops more frequent Divine Orbs, Valdo's Puzzle Boxes and Voidborn Reliquary Keys. Though I can assure it about the blue ones, I can't confirm this buff has any direct effect in getting Valdo's Puzzle Boxes and Reliquary Keys though. I totally agree that the blue-yellow is the best combination. This surely yields the highest raw amount of currency by multiplying blue wisp currency drops with yellow wisps. I also agree with the pink-yellow combination granting you many more chances at rare drops such as uniques. This combo also has the strongest interaction with Archnemesis item conversion modifiers that convert all loot into currency, scarabs and other items. This is exactly what I was talking about in the loot conversion section of this video. An even combination of rainbow can be quite hard to get. Having all three colors is not only great for the loot, but also insanely difficult, or as I'd like to call it, a Uber map. And yes, quantity, rarity, and pack size of your maps do scale with the league mechanic. Rarity has no impact on Wildwood vendors, nor wisps gathered in the Wildwood. Finally, it's time to cover the effect of other league mechanics on this. So basically, the best ones are Abyss, Legion, Ambush, and Torment, followed by Delirium, Harbingers, and Beyond on the second rank. The rest of them are quite meh, and Ultimatum is trash. Gosh, I've always hated that. So if you enjoyed this video, consider throwing a like and subbing to the channel. And thank you for watching.